MATLAB stands for Matrix Laboratory. Matrices are the basic data structure in MATLAB. MATLAB provides us with some useful functions and tools for creating and manipulating matrices. There's the zeros function, which creates an m by n zero matrix. There's the ones function, which creates an m by n ones matrix, a matrix with all of its elements equal to 1. There's the I function, which creates an n by n identity matrix. There's the diag function, which creates a diagonal matrix. Here it creates a 3x3 diagonal matrix with the values of A, B, and C on the diagonal. We can use the colon operator to specify all the columns or all the rows of a matrix. And there is matrix multiplication, A times B. Let's try some of these functions in MATLAB. Let's first construct a matrix A. We have first row 1, 2, 3, second row 4, 5, 6, third row 7, 8, 9. We can access elements of the matrix A directly. For instance, the element in the second row, third column, should be a 6. We can access a submatrix of A. The first and second rows and the second and third columns, for instance, the first and second rows and the second and third columns should be 2, 3, 5, 6. We can access all of the elements in the first row using the colon operator, or we can access all of the elements in the first column using the colon operator. That will give us a column vector. MATLAB stores matrices in an array, so it's very easy to look at the storage by just using a single index into A, and that will be going down columns, so down the first column 147, and then you concatenate the second column 258, and then the third column 369. So it's possible to access elements in the matrix A just using a single index. There's also a end variable, so we can look at the first row and then 2 to the last element in the first row, the second column to the last element, the last column, and that would be 2, 3. Because the first row is 1, 2, 3. Finally, we can assign elements directly. So we can assign the first element of A to 10 using A1, 1 equals 10. MATLAB also has functions that can create matrices. The zeros function can create here a 3x2 matrix, 3 rows, 2 columns. The ones function can create here a 2x3 matrix, 2 rows, 3 columns, all consisting of ones. The I function can create the identity matrix. Here it's the 2x2 identity matrix. And the diag function can create a diagonal matrix. Here it is a diagonal matrix with a 1 and a 2 along the diagonal, so it is a 2x2 matrix. We can also use diag to create a banded matrix. Here I put 2, 2, 2 on the diagonal, so this is a 3 by 3 matrix, and then minus one, minus one, one below the diagonal, and minus one, minus one, one above the diagonal. So that's the 3 by 3 matrix that looks like this. In an application, you would typically want the size of the matrix to be a parameter. So here we look at a 4 by 4 matrix. You can construct the same type of boundary banded matrix using the diag function and the ones function. So here we put 2 along the diagonal. So we have a one row n columns, so a row vector of ones that is consisting of 4 ones, n ones. So this is a 2 along the diagonal, a -1, 1 below the diagonal, and a -1, 1 above the diagonal. And then we get a 4 by 4 banded matrix. MATLAB can also multiply matrices. Here I've constructed 2 matrices, A with 1, 2 in the first row, 3, 4 in the second row, and B with minus 3, minus 4 in the first row, 4, 5 in the second row. So this is 2 2 by 2 matrices. We can multiply them using the star operator, and that gives us a 2 by 2 matrix, which is the multiplication of A times B. You can try that on paper. I can also construct a row vector X, say 1, 2, 3. If we try to multiply X times itself, that would be multiplying a 1 by 3 matrix times a 1 by 3 matrix. MATLAB will not like that. It says incorrect dimensions for matrix multiplication. We can multiply these matrices. So if we take this row vector and multiply it against its transpose, which is a column vector, that would be the scalar product, 1 times 1 plus 2 times 2 plus 3 times 3, which is 1 plus 4, 5 plus 9. That should give us 14.
Some numerical methods require matrix algebra. For example, we'll use matrix algebra to solve a system of nonlinear equations and to solve some partial differential equations. The matrix tools in MATLAB will make programming so much easier. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.